In this video, I'm going to create a very simple cell phone animation like this one. Let me show you. Well, it's a very simple basic After Effects animation. I start off by creating a simple phone here in Illustrator and extracted those elements in all separate layers and rename them so that I'll be able to recognize them in After Effects. So I won't do that process. I assume by now you've already done this step, and so here in After Effects we'll create it from scratch. So Control I on the keyboard to import, so select that layer and make sure you import it as a composition and retain layer size. So it shows me a copy because I've already done that, so no harm. I'll open that again and I'll pick the color white background. Just lock that background. And first off, I need the animation of the speaker, so let's hit the S button to show up the scale. So hit that stopwatch back and make sure you unlock that constraint proportions so that we scale only in the X axis, so make it a 0. So let's see the animation. It's a bit fast, I think. Well, let's do some easy ease there, hitting F9 or right click on keyframe assistant. Easy ease, maybe you won't be able to see this screen recording, it's out of the border. So in case if you want to do that, it's F9 on the keyboard. So go in the graph editor and make sure you select these points and make sure you are in the speed graph. Same with this, you won't be able to see this recording, but there's a little option to tick speed, edit speed graph, so make sure you check on that option. So we'll do something like this kind of graph. Put that back. I think it's very, very fast. Okay, that's okay for now. And from here on, I'll animate the screen. Same with this S. Unlock the constraint proportions. Go to the end frame, put a stopwatch and back. And this time I'll scale the Y axis. 0. So hit F9 on the keyboard, go to the timeline, speed graph, and just tweak these handles so that it comes in gradually and speeds up and slows down that way. So the animation might not that be smooth because I'm recording the screen and doing the project as well, so I apologize for that. Alright, so far so good. So at this point in time, I want the button to start spinning and zooming in. Not zooming in actually, it's scaling up. So scale S and hit Shift and R to bring up the rotation controls. So put a keyframe and move that a little and go back and set the scale to 0 and I don't know, the rotation to maybe some random numbers that way. Same with this F9 graph editor and just zoom it a little bit in order to see the graph, the handles I mean, sorry. So put on, just tweak that handle and let's see what we get here. I think it's a little fast. Maybe we can animate the phone itself now. I mean the blue background. So at this point in time, I want it to start. So same scale there. Just move that forward, and no need to unlock that constraint proportion. So hit zero. Same technique, F9. Go to the graph editor and just tweak some the handles here. Let's see what we got here. Alright, it's coming a little slower than I am thinking it should be. Make it a bit faster here. I think some more. Alright, that's good. So I think I should trim the compositions to 6 seconds. Hit N on the keyboard, right click, trim to comp area. Trim comp to work area. So far, so good. So in the original example, I added some flares to this and fades out, then circle burst. So right about here, just collapse this layer. I need the copy of the screen layer to duplicate to use it as a mask. So click off the, if you're clicking on a layer, just make sure you click off the layer, make sure you don't select any layers, and just draw some rectangles, maybe like this for the flare or glare, I don't know what do you call that. So let's rotate it somewhere about there, and I think it should be good here. So right about here, I'll hit P on the keyboard to bring up the position of that layer. Put a keyframe and right about there, move it below. So early again, so make sure you hit F9 and the same technique. So there you have it. Think let's bring this layer down just below the layer that we duplicate earlier. So hit F4 in case if you don't see this track mat layer. So put the alpha mat screen. So in that way, that affects only inside that screen. So that's that. And I need some more transparency. So just play with the blending mode, say soft light. I don't know what to put. Depends on your personal taste. Overlay. I think I should stick with soft light. Well, that's that. Maybe you shouldn't do any easier. So yeah, that kind of look more better than the easy version. So that's that, and now we need to fade this out. So we need to reverse the animation so that it pops off that way again. So hit U to bring up the animation properties. Just control and paste that, and right click. And sorry again guys, you won't be able to see the recording because it's beneath the record area. So go to keyframe assistant, and there will be an option called time reverse keyframe. So make sure you select that, so it adds the reverse animation for that. U, the same technique. V, go to keyframe assistant and reverse frames, and that way it matches the same exact animation speed. So right about here again, I need the screen to go off. Keyframe assistant, reverse frame. Sorry, I did a mistake. I don't need to bother the duplicate one, I need the original one. So you copy, paste. Good. I need the animation copied, pasted. Keyframe assistant, time reverse. So that way, right about there. The body, you, same rule apply here. Keyframe assistant and time reverse keyframes. So we have that kind of animation. I think we need to bring this more way ahead than that. Alright, let's have a look what we got here. Alright, it might not be the same exact animation as we have here, but well, it's kinda cool. Make sure you turn on the motion blur for the layers and for the composition. Let's see how it looks with motion blur. So it looks way too cool than without the motion blur. So at this point in time, in the original example, I added some circle burst. So I've made some After Effects template called circle burst. Make sure you go and download it in my website www.gfxfirm.com. So I'm not going to be recreating the circle burst. I'm going to use the burst 5 in this for this project. So make sure you go ahead and download that. It's free. It's a very simple burst, but it's kind of nice to have it. So just position in the middle somewhere there, so that way you can have them. You can try another different circle, say number 2. Just drop that. It's very very easy to use it. Just off that, I think somewhere around here. That way you can have a different kind of. So that's that. So let's have a final look at what we got here. Cool, that's all for this time guys. Make sure you go and visit my website. I'll put a link to the project files down in the description below, so you'll be able to download the exact same file. And make sure to download the circle burst pack as well. It's a simple animation, but it's sometimes time saving. So as you can see here, I don't need to create that circle burst anymore because I've already made it and I can use it right away. So it's kind of handy. So make sure you check that out. And that's all I have for this time. And hopefully in the next coming weeks, I'll be able to show you some more techniques and some more tips for some cool animation in After Effects. So stay tuned and please subscribe to this channel. And thanks for watching guys.